Hey, what's up, guys? Been making some progress on the double fix. After I got off the camera with you guys, I went straight to work again. I fixed the head, got the head exactly where I want it to be, and I also primed them, drilled them, put the the ribs on them, and just right now did a few more modifications on the gun. You know, on the death spitter. So, let me show you what I've done and what my plan is today, what I'm going to be doing. Okay. As you can see right here, I've already drilled out the two holes. So we're ready. And right here, you can see the ribs that I made. And I blended them in with the others. So that way, you know, you can't even tell it was there. Did it on both sides. And as you can see, it's a better angle there. How well it came out. I don't know if I can zoom in on that. And there we go. Now with the head, I blended them in nicely, nice and primed, ready to go. I still want to shave just a tad bit more right here, just to kind of give them a more of a swoop, and you know, this is the way he was, I guess, cultured. Don't know a better word right now, but that's him. Now today, this is what I did. Looks like a normal death spitter. When I turn it around, off one of the arms, I cut off that goop ball. And what I did was, with this cable that goes into his arm, I had cut it and then burnt it, you know, with a lighter until it almost melted, and then pushed it real quick into the gun. So now it looks like it was always part of this gun, which it wasn't. With the green stuff, I basically gooped it on, shaped it to the ball, and I paid attention, a lot of great detail. Right here, you see how he got his fingers, kind of a deal, over the gun, and then I just shaped it into it and then blended in, because it's going to be this part of the arm that's going to be about right there. And I'm going to shape it into this goop ball and make it look like it was a morphed weapon. And that's what we have as a modification for this gun. And it's bored out and everything and ready for priming. Okay, these are the weapons in his arms that I'm going to be, you know, priming today. Now, here's a scything talon that I cut in half because the arm did not fit or look right in the socket here. So I had to cut them, and I have to put green stuff on them, and I'll be doing that right now. And this right here is green stuff that I rolled yesterday. And you can see it still, you know, bends and does the stuff that I want it to do, because this is going to be right here. Let me see. Where you got the head right here. You see how his head's up, and you got that little void that's right there. I'm going to put, like, tendons, I guess you would call them. And so that way, you know, when his head's like this, you got him longer on this side and shorter on the other, and I can bend him or do whatever I need him to do, put them really close together, and then, you know, you could dry brush them, and then it looks like it was part of the model, which it wasn't. And that's what I'll be using this for. And I'll be doing a couple of other things too, because in the body itself, I also want tubes coming out of them and gluing into the weapon and stuff. So make him, basically, he's a bioweapon. That's all he is. You know, he's going to, you know, he comes in, leads the army, he sticks his, you know, scything talons into the ground and just starts shooting away. You know, he's basically a cannon, while his warriors run off and die or do whatever or whatever happens. And his job is just to give heavy cover. So my goal today is doing the final details of modifying modifying the arms so that way it looks decent. Then I'm going to prime them. After, hopefully, well, what I want to do, because I do have some more time, is go ahead and start dry brushing them in Skull White and begin the detailing. So I really want to get this done in the next 2 days, this project. At least the assembly part of it, and then we'll go into high detail, which means, you know, carapace, putting spikes on, so I want to change up his spikes a little bit, do something a little bit different. I'm also looking at his tail, because I might do something different with his tail. I don't know yet. This is, like I said, it's just a bunch of drawings, a bunch of things in my head, you know, that I just keep staring at him, and I know that I want him to be completely unique and different, and, you know, when you see him on the battlefield, he's just, you know, something that you just kind of, whoa, you know, is he actually a warrior? How did you do it? So, that's what I'm looking at. But in the game itself, how he would be played, he would be played as a normal warrior. But what I would do is keep him basically back. I would keep him in range, you know, of, you know, where he needed to shoot and keep firing and get cover saves for the rest of the warriors and, of course, my gaunt horse and everything else. And then he'd be backed up by Carnifex, judging by how many points that we're, you know, playing the game. So, you know, I may not be able to keep him, you know, hidden away forever, you know. Apparently I'm going to have to move him and keep him moving, but my main goal is to keep him alive and keep him with cover saves, because I want him to be, of course, everything's going to be glued. I'm not going to magnetize him, because of the detail that I want to put into it, he's just going to be a straight shooter. So I like to keep him alive. You know, maybe he's also an objective. You know, his possibilities are crazy, but that's the object. So I'll try to get another video up. If I can get all those goals completed today, I will be filming all the way through. So I'll just put up a quick video and show you an update on the Devil Fix. Thanks for watching. It's Rim.